March is National Colon Cancer Month, and it can be a difficult subject to talk about. But we're sitting down with Dr. Sharon Thompson about the signs and the symptoms and the ways you can best protect yourself.
Whenever you talk about cancer, it's obviously a really scary thing for a lot of people, but prevention is always key. There's a lot of ways to screen for certain cancers, but a lot of people sometimes avoid it, especially when we're talking about colon cancer, and it's one of the deadliest cancers in the country. So March is National Colon Cancer Awareness Month. Joining us this morning, Dr. Sharon Thompson, to talk about ways to prevent it. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
I was reading that we're going to lose like 50,000 people in 2018 because of this.
Yeah, and it's really a travesty because it's preventable. Colon cancer is very slow growing, and it has precancerous stages that you can catch, treat, and prevent a subsequent cancer.
Okay, it's about the same for men and women. 1 in 22 mm-hmm. men will get it, 1 in 24 women. But let's talk about some of the risk factors.
Yeah, so there's some things that we know we shouldn't do. Smoking.
Right.
If you smoke, this is a good time to think about quitting. Heavy alcohol use will increase your risk, but then there's some things you can't control. Family history of colon
cancer. And your age.
Your age, as we get older, we're at higher risk. Also, there are some genetic diseases that increase the risk of colon cancer. Having polyps in the colon increase the risk.
Okay.
So this makes screening so important.
Okay.
Because you can't control those genetic factors, but we can catch it early. We can prevent or treat it.
If you've had other types of cancer, is that
some
a likelihood?
Some other types of cancer for you or your family members can increase the risk, because we know there's some cancers that cluster in families.
Okay.
So having one of those can increase your risk as well. Breast, ovarian, other gastric cancers can increase
the
risk.
The age of 50, how often should you go get that checked?
So, great question. In general, screening starts at age 50 for the general population. People with those risk factors we just talked about may have to screen earlier, and you should talk to your doctor about that. If you get a colonoscopy, which is the best test that looks at the entire colon, and that's completely normal, 10 years.
10 years.
So that's not bad.
Good. I'm good for 10 more years
good
then.
Good for 10 years, you get a completely negative screen. There are other screening tests, though, that have a more frequent screening regimen that you can get every year, every 2 years, and your doctor can talk to you about those. So for people who think that colonoscopy is scary or a friend had a bad experience, there are other ways to screen as well, but you want to get screened.
I did have a colonoscopy. Mm-hmm. The scariest part of it, you know, they tell you no food. Yeah. I had a piece of gum in my mouth. The nurse went crazy on me. She was so mad at me.
But it wasn't so bad, was
no,
it? I've
it,
had
it
one
wasn't.
As well, yeah. And it really wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Let's talk about prevention.
Mm-hmm.
Exercise being one of those?
Definitely. Those things that keep us healthy will help decrease our risk of cancer also. So lots of veggies. So veggies that we always talk about.
But I also see fruits, so I'm okay.
Vegetables are the best. Eat lots of fruit. A well-balanced, diverse diet. Moderate alcohol use. Stop smoking, like we talked about. Exercise is going to make your entire body healthier.
Uh-huh.
So definitely, and maintain a healthy weight.
Okay.
And those things are going to help you stay healthy in general and avoid cancers and lots of other health conditions that are not.
I'm
so
not
great
sure
for
who
you.
Spelled weight there. It's not W-A-I-T.
And don't wait.
That's a way you could look at that. Do you ever see a day someday when we'll be able to wipe out any types of cancer?
Boy, that's my dream. That's the dream, isn't it? But the thing about cancer is it's not one. We call it one word, but it's not one thing.
Yeah.
And we're getting closer and closer to figuring out what each one is and targeting our prevention strategies and our treatments to that particular disease.
Yeah. Dr. Thompson, thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome.
It's always great having you
on. Go get screened.